Hi, I'm Katherine Spilios. I'm the Director of Instructional Labs in the Department of Biology at Boston University. And I'm going to talk to you today about active learning. And so what I'm going to present to you in the next few minutes is just a quick overview of what this module will entail. So first, let's just take a step back and think about the typical experience in a lecture scenario or in any classroom scenario. Quite often, there is one person up at front who is teaching, and they are conveying information in a manner in which they might think is very clear, when in reality, your students may in fact have very different ideas of what you're talking about if they have any idea what you're talking about at all. In fact, some of them may be, who knows, sleeping or looking out the window. Their minds could be all over the place. Active learning is one way to engage your students to help them fully understand and gain a deeper sense of the information that you are conveying. So I'm going to present to you a very simple definition of active learning, and that's active learning is anything that involves students doing things or thinking about what they are doing. So I think any of us could have written that definition by ourselves, right? I mean, that is very straightforward. You take the words active and learning and you put them together, and that's what you have. Now, a little bit later in this module, you'll be reading a paper by Scott Freeman, which was published in 2014. And in that paper, they present a consensus definition. So I'm not going to share that definition with you, but I do want you to pay attention to that overall consensus definition and how that definition was arrived at. So I want to share with you an interesting piece of data that was just published by the National Center for Biotechnology Information. They found that in the year 2000, the attention span of humans was right around 12 seconds, and that has dropped precipitously to a length of 8 seconds in the year 2013. This is likely due to the proliferation of various things that are grabbing our attentions, whether it's social media or technology or, well, you name it, and I'm sure you could name everything that's vying for your attention. Now, think about how this will play out in a classroom. If our students really do have that attention span that lasts for about 8 seconds, we, as instructors, have to be continually refining how we are communicating with our students to ensure that they are engaged. And now, those researchers were also looking at some comparative studies. And one thing that they found was that our attention span, humans, with 8 seconds, is actually 1 second shorter than that of the goldfish. So our students may in fact have a shorter attention span than the goldfish. So I want to provide a framework that you've seen before in prior videos, and that's Bloom's taxonomy. And so we will be using this framework as we discuss active learning. And so by employing various means to engage our students, we're giving them the tools to build their ideas from simple to complex, and also to go from concrete information to abstract reasoning. So let's take a step back and think about what active learning is giving to our students as a whole, in a big picture. Not only are we encouraging their engagement, we're also giving them the opportunity to reinforce concepts and skills that they are learning. Through active learning techniques, we're also giving them immediate feedback, whether it's from you as the instructor or from their peers in class. And by working with their peers, we are fostering a community of learners. And by doing so, we're also giving our students the opportunity to create personal connections to the material. And by doing so, we're giving our students ownership over some material. And when our students own material, it enables them to dive deeper and really form those lasting, meaningful learning opportunities. And so I'm going to stop with that list, but I encourage you to take a moment and think about what active learning can do for you as an instructor, as well as for your students. So here's a quick overview of how our module is set up. Of course, we're talking about active learning, but within that, we've broken it down to two topics, critical thinking and teamwork. So within critical thinking, we'll first look at problem-based learning. Problem-based learning is a teaching approach that challenges students to learn the concepts and principles by applying them to real-life problems. Within inquiry-based labs, we're giving students the opportunity to engage in many of the same activities and thought processes as scientists conducting research. Cooperative learning is the use of small groups so that students working together are maximizing their own as well as their peers' learning. And peer instruction gives our students the opportunity to articulate, defend, and refine their ideas as well as solutions to problems within the class. And then finally, we will end with a discussion on assessing active learning and also assessment using active learning techniques. So the next steps in this module is to read the paper by Scott Freeman that I mentioned just a minute ago, and then we'll ask you to post on a discussion board as well. But before you go, I want to leave you with a Chinese proverb, and that is, tell me and I forget, teach me and I remember, involve me and I learn.